In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create and animate this comedy title animation. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. We'll use a bunch of different animation techniques you can use for any other project as well. Better stick around till the end. First of all, we create comps for the letters we need. We name the first one letter 1. Width 700 pixels, height 1000 pixels. Okay, next we grab the title tool and add a capital C. Random grotesque medium is available on Adobe fonts. We center the letter, then center the text layer as well using the alignment tool. Next we use the effects and presets window above to add a gradient ramp to the letter. Set the start above, the end of the ramp below the letter. And choose a bright blue. And a dark, almost black blue. We add lots of ramp scatter to avoid color bending. We duplicate the text layer, move it down, swap fill and stroke, set the stroke width to 50, and change the colors of the gradient ramp. A sunny yellow and a magenta-ish red. Then we link the source text of the lower layer to the top one. Why? Later. For more details, we add a layer style. We right-click on the layer, layer styles, and we choose bevel and emboss. We open the bevel and emboss property, size 10. Highlight color, white. Shadow color, purple. Okay. We select the top layer and add bevel and emboss as well. And adjust some settings. Direction, down this time, which engraves the inner part. Size 6. Soften 10. Angle 105. Altitude around 4. Highlight mode normal. Color a bright yellow. Shadow mode normal as well. Shadow color a dark purple again. Awesome. That's one letter. Now we simply duplicate the comp 5 times. 2, 3, 4, and 5. And replace the letters. As we've linked the source text earlier, we only need to change it in the top layer. O, M, E, P, and Y. Awesome. Next, let's create the main comp. Name it Title Animation. 1920 by 1080 pixels this time. And first of all, we add all the letters. Roughly position them. We use the selection tool for that. From left to right. And let's move letter 3 up the stacking order, letter 5 down. Let's scale them, kind of randomly. We open all scale properties, 55%, 55%, 50%, 50%, and how about 59 for a change? And 50% again. Next, we rotate some of them slightly. A C, minus 3. 0, 0, how about 8, minus 5, and 0. Now, let's finalize the positions. Here are the position properties so that you can actually see the values. Awesome. That's basically the end of the title animation. If you like this video so far, please give it a thumbs up. I'd really appreciate it. Thanks very much. Now, we're gonna animate all these letters backwards. Let's start with the O. I think it should jump in from the left. So we solo the layer and set a position and scale keyframe at 21 frames. We activate the rulers, Command or Control R, to add a guide, as floor. Then we use the anchor point tool to move the anchor point down to the bottom. Back to the selection tool. At 18 frames we set a position keyframe. Deselect constraint proportions and set scale to 60 and 40%. At 14 frames we move it up. Set scale to 40 and 60%. Squeeze it in the other direction. At 11 frames, we set scale to 60 and 40% and move it left and back down. At 10 frames, scale is 50 and the letter is still on the ground. At 5 frames, it is up in the air again and almost out of the screen. Scale is 40 and 60 again. At the beginning, it is back on the ground and out of the screen. We use the Convert Vertex tool to create two nice arcs. At 24 frames, we set scale to 55 and 45%. At 27 frames, back to 50 and 50%. I think we should add Ease In to all keyframes. Awesome, we just animated a jumping O backwards. Next, we want the C to race into the screen. We grab the anchor point tool and move the anchor point to the bottom edge of the C. Then we set a position keyframe at 24 frames. At 18 frames, we move it out of the screen. Then we open the rotation property and set the rotation to minus 30. Set a keyframe. At 24 frames to minus 24. Now we want it to swing a bit more. At 27 frames, it is 39 degrees. At 30 frames, minus 11 degrees. At 34 frames, minus 3 degrees. Awesome! Like it comes to a screeching halt. We should adjust the start point. Next, the M, like MoGraph. We set a scale and rotation keyframe at 34 frames. At 31 frames, the rotation is minus 10 degrees. Scale is up 75%. At 26 frames, rotation is around 40 degrees. Scale, 0. We add Easy Ease In to all keyframes. It seems the C triggers the appearance of the M. I like it. Alright. The E. We set a position, scale and rotation keyframe at 34 frames. Then go to 31 frames and I thought we simply hide it behind the M. We add Easy Ease In to all keyframes. And adjust the start point of the layer. Awesome. Next, the D, letter 5. We use the anchor point tool again and move the anchor point to the bottom of the D. We set a scale and position keyframe at 35 frames. At 31 frames, we move it up, above the screen. And set the scale to 40 and 60%. At 35 frames, we squeeze it. Scale, 60 and 40%. At 38 frames, it is back to 50%. And we add Easy Ease In to all keyframes. Awesome, it's coming together. Last letter, Y. We set a position, scale and rotation keyframe at 42 frames. At 38 frames, we set another scale keyframe. At 36 frames, we rotate it around, minus 180 degrees. Scale 73 and 43%. And we move it right and create an arc out of the motion path. One frame before, we set the scale back to 59%. And move it slightly up. Up and down and up. Set another rotation keyframe. At 31 frames, we move it up and out of the screen. And adjust the motion path. Then we add Easy Ease In to all keyframes. Awesome. There are little details missing though. Let's add CC Bended. Set the start below, the end above the letter, so that nothing is cut off. At 42 frames, we set Bend to minus 10. Set a keyframe. Press U to see the keyframes on the timeline. At 45 frames, it's 7. At 48 frames, minus 3. At 51 frames, 1. And at 54 frames, finally 0. Let's see, much better, right? We select the bend keyframes and copy them. Select letter 4 and go to 34 frames and paste the effect. And adjust the start and end point. And we paste it to letter 3, which is the M. Adjust the start and end point. This time we invert the bend values though. Minus 10 turns into 12, 7 into minus 6, 3, minus 1 and 0 remains. Awesome. That was absolutely worth it. Details matter. On the left side, I've added some videos you might like. Subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell because you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye guys.